A G&L Tribute Series Fallout guitar.
Kind of a cute looking piece of kit, but it looks like the Fallout fell out. So we are going to do our best to make that go away, so at least you don't get your shirt cut on it and look at it like a big scabby scab.
So the whole thing is getting new strings and a setup anyway. So this would be much easier tackled with the neck removed, and that is what I'm going to do.
Okay, when it's really nasty like this, what I like to do is take a bit of acetone and just soften that broken edge a little bit, and that'll also melt the finish a little bit around there, but that's okay. And then they've actually busted right through, believe it or not, all the paint and the sanding sealer, right down to the bare wood. So before I add any color, I want to try and seal the open grain, because otherwise my color is just going to go right inside.
Yeah, we also got this little corn flake here, so it's ready to fall off. We're going to get some CA glue, get this spun around the right way, and put some thin CA glue in under that crack. Is it moving? Yeah, I can move it. Okay.
Sorry, fan noise, using huffy shit. So anyway, I didn't film it, but anyway, we took the little tiny tip and we let it drizzle down in there, and then I pushed it down with my finger, and I sprayed the accelerator on it. What a concept. This thing hit hard, man. Woohoo!
So I started playing around with a little color matching. I like that a lot. It's definitely, and I did seal this with a coat of the Glue Boost Fill and Finish. And looks like I'm probably going to have to go two passes with the color to, get past seeing the grain, but I'll attempt to do a little movie magic.
So after a few hours of filling and chilling, now I'm just at the very end, gently sanding away here. And then we'll get the Wheel of Death out and polish it up, and it'll be as good as it can be without pulling out any spray apparatus. That would be the only way to actually make something like this vanish. But you won't see it anymore. This will all be shiny. And also, I got to get the Rickenbacker needs the Wheel of Death treatment as well, behind me. Alright, so I'm just working through all the grits. Get myself right down to 2,000. You can always see what your end result's going to be like when it's wet, because that's what it'll be like when it's shinier. Once we polish it. Did I get there? Do I have 2,000 in here somewhere? I thought I did. I could be wrong. I might have to get it out of the old drawer. Now I'm all wet.
Okay, I've been asked about this a bunch of times. This is a 7-inch sander / polisher variable speed. And what I've done is use the mounting holes for the sidearm handles on both sides, if you're left-handed or right-handed, and just mounted it to the bench. And this is the Presta Ultra Buffing System. If you care to look it up, that's what that is, from Presta. And there's another one and another one and a whole bunch of things to get it super shiny.
Today's string choice are these. Away we go. What's this thing called again? Oh yes, this is the G&L Tribute Series Fallout.
which is what it did. It fell.
Okay. The usual drill. The strings are on it. Let's see how straight or unstraight or lack of straight the neck could be. And it's could use a little bit. Not much. It's close. I'll give it a little turn. Let's see what happens. Well, I kind of thought, seeing as it's a tribute series and it's made overseas, it might have been metric truss rod adjustment, but no, it is 5/16ths of an inch is the one that works it. I'll just have a little peek here, see what happens. I think we're going to be fine. It turned quite nicely. Yeah, that's perfect. Let's just see what the string action's all about, string height, and go through it.
Okay, survey says the bass strings are way too high. And then, whoop! Hey, the D string's good. G string's good. B string too low. E string way too low. Okay, so we gotta jack around with a bunch of that, but we'll get it.
I wonder what hex key runs these? Let me guess. Is it metric at this end? Yeah, it's metric at this end, but not at that end. Check twice. Strip things once.
Okay, I'm gonna do pickup height before I do intonation, because I can see that these are all way too close to the strings, especially now that I brought the string action down to where it should be. So that's what I'm going to do first, because the pickups will suck the strings down if they're too close to the guitar. That's way too much dingling. That one, probably live with that. Does it even move? Yeah, hey. What do you know? An economically priced guitar, and everything actually works. A little bit of intonation. Might be out of a job any moment. Thanks for hanging out, folks. All the links to things that stinks are down below. Special shout out to all my patrons for making me continue. Well, you don't make me, but enabling me to continue. Making movies for yous. A string seems to be a little flat, so I still have a job. As does the E string. Well, that's it. I think. Guitar. GNL Fallout. Thanks for hanging out, folks. Be good to each other. Cheers.